says his favorite player is Bradley Beal. See a little bit of that in his stroke here to start the third quarter. Brown on the drive. Five to shoot. Chandler got Nembhard in the air. Love with the rebound. Dariq Whitehead, top 10 junior, the Euro step and the bucket. The first of the game for Dariq Whitehead.
Yeah, he can shoot it really well from the outside, but I like the way he bodies up inside defensively.
Oh, Dariq Whitehead, unbridled power. Final seconds melt away. Montverde has climbed to the mountaintop of high school basketball yet again.
Coach, and Kevin Boyle is as gifted as they come in the game. You can say Montverde is the gold standard of high school basketball.
Committed to Duke University. Yeah!
What do you guys think about this week coming up?
About NIBC? Oh, it's gonna get spicy for sure. We're gonna come out on top.
We are working on filling all the way to the spots and all the way through. I'm concerned with, you know, Sunrise, IMG, Oak Hill playing as hard as hell. We have to cut move. We're gonna try to switch it out. We're gonna have to tell you, we're gonna have 35 points. 40 points in the whole game. That's what we're gonna score. If we don't get out of transition, get the offense and move like hell. We just reversed the ball before and you drove right from here after like three passes. And it spread the floor to give you the opportunity. They're going to key on you. If we stay and throw one pass, you are gonna have a frustrating night. If you move, you both are gonna have space when the ball gets reversed to make plays. If you try to do it, you're just standing around.
What is the biggest thing you personally, a personal goal?
Personal goal is really just to prove that I'm the best player in the country. That's really it. Like, I'm the best player in the country and, you know, make sure there's no questions or concerns about it.
National Director of Recruiting, Paul Biancardi. I'm Ted Emmerich. After the game we saw just a moment ago, Sunrise Christian's win over IMG, I'm on board, Paul. Just the kind of elite competition the NIBC is going to deliver, and it should be no different with this game.
Tonight we have two Hall of Fame coaches and teams that are loaded with talent at the next level for college and NBA prospects as well. Two of the giants in the high school game. This should be a great one.
Montverde, the number one team in the country, defending Geico National Champions.
The guys to come here and wait a year or two, that tells me a lot about their character. These are very competitive guys because Montverde Academy is not for everybody.
Dylan Mitchell living above the rim. One of those 10 you
come. Whitehead, one of the most complete players in the high school game. Smooth, fluid, a power jumper who seeks out to dunk on you. He's going to play for John Shire next year.
For Kevin Boyle's team, 86-51 on opening night of the NIBC. The defending Geico National Champions look just about as good as ever.
They were in that same seventh grade class together.
Right.
Huh? Hey, I got one out of the two.
Ah.
done that second grade. I'll be down there. We're in the film room right now?
I would think so.
Coming to Montverde is the hardest thing you have ever done. You were a big fish in a small pond, wherever you came from. You come to Montverde, now you are a fish in the ocean.
They had a plan for me, you know, get me in there, do 6 months, and then, you know, leave after, you know, being the top three picks. That's pretty much, you know, with the guys they got coming in, I feel like that was going to be the best route for me to go, you know, accomplish what I need to accomplish.
I was making sure. Can
you
and then go get
Chick-fil-A? Nah, this black bear.
Raymond right here?
Look at him. Get the camera on him right
here. Raymond, he's working right now. It's a rare sight. He ain't never working.
Oh, God.
Look, see? He got his glasses on. You don't never see this too much. We gonna leave him to it, though. It's rare. I'm gonna let him finish his work. It's rare to see that. Look, Coach Ray.
And my boy wearing number 0. He better rep it good. Rep it good. Huh?
Indiana Duke is the AC.
Rivals, new
Yohan Tough
coming though, out tonight, apparently.
Yohan Tough. But he's not.
I'm gonna be like 99.
I'm gonna comment on that and be like, sorry.
Where do you see that at?
Ray bouncy.
He bouncy as shit.
That's Cowboy.
Yes, sir.
Kentucky?
Not yet.
He's not even going to Kentucky.
You're not lying. Let me stop, bro.
You lying. I told him, let's be great at Montverde together. He told me, you already know, brother. And guess what? You don't see him here, right?
One versus two here tonight. Could you imagine better players, better teams taking on each other than what we're about to see?
I couldn't personally, but the NIBC did when they envisioned this type of atmosphere, this tournament, this league. This is the best high school basketball players in the country going head to head, and we've got a front row seat, 15 ranked players in the ESPN Top 100.
Score all day. Every time we move, we just drove to the basket freely, and then we'll get guys in the post.
Play harder than the other
first team national player of the year, first half. So there's no just play.
Oh, the ball! Gets his own shot there. No question. Whitehead pulls up.
It's a joke. It's not real anymore. He's just a pro.
Deontay Jordan somehow got to go. Whitehead pulls the trick. Devin's junior, Huchipino, bobbles it. Now takes it up off balance. It's good. Shot clock is off. Wait for about 10 seconds. Deontay George, the lane is open. It's locked. Puts it back up and in. 6 seconds. Huchipino. Clock winding down. He'll fire it at the buzzer.
Deal with what you gotta deal with right now. But you gotta clear your head. You gotta clear your head, you gotta clear it real quick. Alright? You gotta clear your head real quick. We got another one tomorrow. Alright? You guys played a hell of a game. Alright? Came up short. But we got another game tomorrow, so we gotta clear our heads.
Well, you know, overall, you know, it wasn't, you know, it's tough, but you know, we have to pick our heads up and be ready to play tomorrow night. You know, you can't have one loss turn into two losses, you know. Guys, again, you gotta get dressed and be ready to play and be really focused. I mean, this is an incredibly huge game. Let's get, you know, great teams usually, when they don't play well or lose, usually respond.
We saw an absolute classic on this floor with Montverde and ING. Montverde came up a little short. Will we see another classic here tonight? Whitehead on the other end. Got to get Grady Dick going.
Yeah.
He comes off the screen. Good way to come out of a timeout.
Dariq Whitehead.
Crossover.
My goodness.
Cuckoo right now. Breaking third. Get the roll, but it was Chukwu doing the dirty work. Taking it personal. Here he is. Dylan Mitchell on the other end. He's been really good. Montverde Academy 53, Sunrise Christian 44.
An excellent defensive effort for Montverde. It was a great job of responding after a loss from IMG last night. A collective defensive team unit.
What does Montverde mean to you?
I mean, obviously, Coach Boyle, his history with, you know, getting guys to where they need to be. I mean, you know, why is here? It seemed like, you know, it's a lot, but everything he's telling you here is really to get you to the NBA and be successful. I mean, every guy he had who's been in the pros, you know, has been successful, so why not come here and do the same thing as where if you was to go to any other school, you know, most coaches let you do what you want, you know, not get on you for certain things, and where here they can hold you accountable for what you need to do. So I feel like that was just the best thing for you.
Oldest in the family, what you do as far as I'm a basketball player at Montverde, and then just say something about yourself, describe yourself.
In terms of okay. Like what I like to do outside of basketball?
Yeah, who you are as a person, your personality.
Okay.
Thank you. Describe your emotions when you heard that your grandmother passed away and what you've been through this week. And my condolences to you. I know it couldn't have been easy for you in a pandemic to go through what you went through losing a family member.
I mean, they hurt me. Like, I was, you know, down here, you know, getting ready for practice, and my mom didn't even actually tell me. She wanted me to, you know, find out later so that I had a game the next day, so she didn't want to let me know. But then I found out, you know, from going on social media, and when I found out, it hurt me. You know, me and my grandmother, we was always close, you know. When I found out, it was just like, everything just stopped.
me in Phoenix, Arizona. We played Duncanville in Wausau. Hopefully we win. That's our main goal.
So good. I'm about to go in here. Get a quick shoot around in before we play Duncanville tonight.
Again, we have to get rest tonight. You know, we're all in time. We had to go to the workout. We're all mid depth. We got to be ready to go tomorrow. So just take care of business. We're better overall than them, but they do have a unique style that takes some getting used to. And if you're not ready to play, you can lose to them real easy.
This is the start of two teams I think I understood how big this game was going to be, but no one back out to prevent Whitehead from slamming it down for both sides. Ronaldo steps right through, and that's beautiful footwork from the floor. Barnes, and here comes Hood-Shafino. Breaks down the defense. Whitehead hangs, scores, and one.
Kwame Evans, my goodness, the ability to recover.
Thank you.
Get that block.
Easy dish. Mitchell with the flush. Demings is going to pull up in transition and connect. Left-hander. Demings gets clear for a second. And you're hot. You are hot because the rim is soft.
Guys, it's a 23-point quarter for that. We got to be tough. We look exhausted. Guys, just stop playing now. They're just driving right by us, tipping the ball, and guys aren't going for rebound. We dominate the first quarter, and then we're not fucking ready to compete.
Listen, okay? Guys, you guys gotta decide right now what you want to have. Either you're going to get run out of this gym, or you're going to start up and fight.
Good feed in low. Renault caught it between two and blue, and makes it a one-possession game.
But he makes the big plays and the crunch time plays.
What an answer.
Anthony Blackson.
Pulling his man, rises up in the air, do just that. And a Whitehead on the other end ties it up. Right through it, missed, but right into the hands of Rahsaan Collier. Said gave it up to Evans, and Kwame Evans ties it up with a triple. And drew contact and is headed to the line. 2-point lead. Duncanville has a timeout left. They won't use it. Demings, good head fake. Hits again!
Again today, we're like, oh, we're better than everybody. We're better than them because we're up 21-7. They're not leaving. They have nothing to lose in the game. They're going to keep playing.
Whitehead for three on Usain. the break. It's a 5-point lead now for Montverde. Not anymore. Dariq Whitehead scheduled. Whitehead posting up Vesesch and over Kane. That would have been a goaltend. It's a goal for Whitehead, who's got 21 to lead all players on the floor.
Either Whitehead called that on his own or Kevin Boyle from the bench. Anytime he gets a mismatch, he goes to that mid-post for that Kobe-style turnaround. Strong comeback win from Montverde.
Moving and cutting as a team the whole first half an hour of practice, and then today we got guarded, we're not cutting back door, we're not moving, we're not cutting, we're not getting offensive rebounds, and those are the things you can do a better job of. And then it's like, well, he's letting his offense affect his defense, and this other guy's bringing it today defensively, but you know, right. Basically you're pounding on the court.
Right.
Like number two up there? You can at least put, can't you change to put a slash my name too? Because Malik can't go.
No, because I see like he put the names of defending.
Yeah.
Like I see your name and I was like, what are they doing? Like, why is your name even up there when it talks about defense?
Because you can't guard me. You can't guard me. Are you crazy?
No, I'm not crazy.
Are you crazy?
It's not.
He goes.
You guard me?
Huh?
You guard me?
Can I guard you?
No. Dehani is your dad.
That's
bro.
Fact.
Why? Yeah. Why did I see Dehani?
Why he had me
on
the bed?
Bro, y'all not understand. I really had him on the bed.
Why did he have you like that?
I stopped going. I just stopped.
But why? You're missing the point. Why did he even have you like this though?
Thank you.
feel it just to be back in the
It feels good, in a good thing, because we've gotten to the point as a program and a team that, unfortunately, if we don't win it, it's like something like we're number three in a lot of polls around, a lot of questions at school, what's wrong with the team, you know? And, you know, they're not number one, they've been number one a lot in the last 10 years. And so it's a good problem that the past teams have established and created. I think we have, you know, great tournament. This is clearly the best in-season high school tournament, you know, every year, you know.
What do you think was key to you guys pulling away with the win tonight?
I really feel like it was defense in the second half. I feel like when we, you know, coach got into us and we picked it up in the second half, that's what changed.
So, what do you think is going to be key against Oak Hill tomorrow?
I could say the same thing. Defense, you know, I could definitely say it's a different, you know, Oak Hill team than we played, you know, a couple weeks ago. So I feel like we got to come out locked in, you know, looking forward to the game as, you know, to be any other game and just play defense and take care, you know, of the important.
Go for a dunk. And now you don't help. This guy sent the flare. Anybody goes to the rim on this, he's
over. It starts right now, just focusing, mentally getting ready for the game. I'm ready to work.
Boyle, displeased.
You see the way Hood Schifino pushes the ball? That's the way Kevin Boyle wants to play all season long. Take it off the miss or from the turnover and advance it with the hit ahead. Duke turned it over.
And Dariq Whitehead with an eruption at the rim. Dog, if you're Oak Hill, but they are big time.
Well, it definitely has something to do with it, the emotional energy tank, and you got a team like Montverde that's coming out, you know, to attack. Speaking about attack, Dariq Whitehead has been in attack mode all game long.
I'm that guy. I ain't never went something like this in my life.
Really, was doing whatever it took to win, and I feel like that's what we did. You know, we locked in on defense. We, you know, owned the glass, and that's what, you know, had us come to the outcome. You know, I feel like the only thing at the end of the month, you know, on the end of the game, that was going through our mind was winning the game. So that's all that matters.
Hardest practice I ever had in my life.
Yeah.
You know, it's just gonna make me put me at the next level, honestly. But I love it here. All the guys are high level. It's just gonna make me a better player, honestly. So I love it. And that's what. Ooh. Stop.
Feel good. As long as Malik don't make it out of Jersey, I feel good. If he make it out of Jersey, then it's going to be a problem. I'm going to obviously have a good game, but after that game, all I know is there's going to be some problems. But the goal is for him to have a great game down here in New Jersey. Yeah, look, see? This is why Jersey is better.
It is.
Got my fellow pal, KBJ. Jersey. Yo, stay up there. You're not from Jersey. KBJ, he's not from Florida.
KBJ, you think he's been there his whole life?
No, he has not. He's been in Jersey his whole life. And then he came down here to coach.
My wife said that I used to have like a crazy annoying New Jersey accent.
Yeah,
maybe. 10 years
ago. Yeah, I heard that. I heard that a lot too.
Yo, you're dressed.
Oh, this one. You don't.
Got that double. Yeah.
There it goes. One hand should be easier.
Great. Each possession, we gotta play. And hopefully there's a good crowd. Those are it's fun to play, you know, away. And there's a crowd, especially the crowd a little loud. That's always for me. I like doing it the best. When we were at St. Patrick, we used to play Elizabeth in front of 5,000 people. We would have 50 fans.
Control the game, guard.
That's what I do.
Focus on where you play it. Like I said, we are our best player. You know, right now, if you're matching up you and him, because you're playing against him right now, in the sense of you're guarding him, he's probably guarding you. You're a better player at this stage. So just relax and play and diversify your game. I don't care about anything. Get 7 or 8 rebounds. I guarantee you, you have a great game.
Welcome to the 2022 Metro Classic. Montverde Academy taking on Camden High School here at the Cure Insurance Arena in Trenton, New Jersey. Two top five teams going at it, doing battle.
With Duke and Montverde, just a national powerhouse. It was last year where they had their 44-game win streak snapped with the hands of Sunrise Christian. Nice feed inside for the slam for Mitchell. Third time's the charm above the rim for the Texas signee. Just a Montverde team that comes at you in waves. A lot of top-end talent and a lot of depth.
22-4, Montverde leads. Oh, good. Put back slam.
That's how you follow the shot.
Whitehead, one of the most complete players in the high school game. Committed to Duke, turned it over. Duke, 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 Duke
first time since going to Montverde. How's it feel to play in front of your home friends?
I mean, it felt good, you know, knowing that this is possibly the last time, you know, before, you know, hope God willing, the next level. It felt good to come home and play in front of family and friends, and especially, you know, get the win. I feel like that was just the main goal, coming home, making sure we won the game, and that's what we did. So, you know, a successful week.
And coming into this game, Camden, one of the top teams in the country, what would your guys' game plan to slow down somebody like DJ Wagner?
I mean, we look at it as any other game. I mean, we just took it as, you know, us playing anybody. And, you know, our main three points, which was defend, rebound, and energy. So we came in with the same mindset and obviously got the job.
This is like a playoff game, you know what I mean? Like a pre-Geico game. And it's a critical game.
Well, everybody give it y'all. That's it. That's all I ask for. Everybody give it y'all. Come on, y'all. My bird on three, family on six. 1, 2, 3. 4, 5, 6, man.
Akara with space. And he throws it down with two hands. He as well. Spears comes up with the steal. 2-on-2 with Holloway. And Whitehead with the block. Huchefino the other way. And a stop with two hands. Montverde enjoying a big lead here. Gets his shot blocked. Now Montverde ahead. Whitehead soars and scores. Huchefino rains it in for three.
Malik Renault inside. A lot of the action and rebounding. Usage rate is about different parts of the game. So how much you involved? Do you just handle? Do you just pass? Do you just shoot? Whitehead does a little bit of everything very well. Dariq Whitehead headed to Duke. Doesn't get much better.
Academy fouls on Dariq Whitehead. That's his second. Teammate.
Close. They try to flush it hard.
Hard. It's Whitehead going upstairs and one.
All game.
Fucking talk more. Keep talking.
To sign stuff, so don't sign anything, don't take pictures with anybody.
Yeah, I see this firsthand. KJ not gonna be playing this weekend. I'm gonna hurt him.
How you been?
Been good.
Yeah.
A couple years ago in the elevator over there. I remember that.
Well, very the same.
Yeah, yeah, same one.
In this hotel for years.
How many years since you were?
Yo. In Greece. Yeah. In Greece. Yeah. Good to see you guys.
You too now. All right.
She's not bigger than me.
That's because it's a pitcher.
I don't think she's bigger than me.
Played here at the Hoop Hall Classic. 40 players ranked in the ESPN 100. A handful of those on display on the floor right now between Montverde and DeMatha. Terrell Ward with the dunk, the two-handed flush. Still a 9-point lead for Montverde. Ward and Whitehead. Not sure how you defend that. That's the Duke sighting, number 5 in the ESPN 100. The number 1 small forward.
Big-time athlete, has great elevation on his jump shot, and he gets to it quick.
It's Sky Clark to the rack and the reverse lay-in. He tore his ACL at the beginning of the 2021.
AAU season, just coming back into form.
Oh, he's just feeling it. The Duke signee has 9 points. Just a balanced effort here. Whitehead, transition opportunity. Good start to the weekend for Montverde.
Yeah, DeMatha gave it all they could. They just ran into a Titan
for Montverde as they put up 86.
Got off to a good start this weekend, but now, you know, it's time to prepare for the Monday game versus the IMG.
You know, they got us early in the year, so now it's time to lock in and prepare for that game. This is a game I've been looking forward to since they beat us. You know, since the buzzer went off and they beat us by one, it's a game I've been looking forward to. So, you know, it comes down to whoever we play in the national championship. So I feel like, you know, this is just another game, but it's also good to get revenge on a team that beat you by 1 point early in the season. But I could definitely say the biggest game of the season is the team we play in the national championship.
Love leading the break. Nice. Future Baylor Bear puts it in.
Oh, I love that float game by Langston Love. Scott Drew, are you watching?
Maybe.
He's watching.
I would say so. Dariq Whitehead, the interception. Again, in transition. Whitehead, count it, and the foul. And that's it. Here at the St. James, number one Montverde knocks off number two IMG in another close battle.
And at the same time, Caleb, I'm gonna see you. You a grown man. What do you mean you're gonna see him? He's a grown man.
It started with Tamar Braxton.
Yes.
He said something to you. He said something. I'm like,
he told him you got one more time. I said, bro.
I wasn't gonna say nothing.
First of all, look. He said, goes to the wing. I walks to the wing. He walks in front of me. What you want me to do? That? No, I'm going to keep walking. You walk in front of me on purpose. I'm not going
to
stop.
It felt good to watch basketball again, you know, at a competitive level, you know? You know, used to see blowouts here and there. Like I said, the tight games make you who you are, you know?
Just on Saturday, Malik Renault side with Class. Bradley, the kick. Don't leave yet. Rebound here for Hachipino. Kalen Hachipino, Indiana signee, Glass good. And a triple-double on Saturday.
Fall asleep out of bounds, but just runs to the rim for a layup. That can't possibly happen, Dariq. You got to be engaged in a way. He has the right to go either way. He can't be that close to him where he just runs right by you for a layup, man. Come on. And just, you know, different things in the game, but you got one rebound right now. Offensive, he got to get involved in the rebound in the game. Okay, it's just too many games where, you know, you could point to this game, maybe it wasn't there. If you go to the tape, I can't analyze every play at halftime. But it's just too many games that you got to get on the glass and make your presence there. Get all over the window. You got to get on the window. I'm begging you to get on the window. You got one rebound at halftime. Oh.
you want to see from either team is Keontae George, the Baylor signee, puts that one in, chance at three.
I want to see Montverde take away that cut.
Lead after the previous free throw. Three ball, Daly, just has not found it, but how about Keontae George with a great...
quickly and rises up.
Inbound. Schifino has it. Oh, turns down the three, gives it to Evans, who hits the three. 2-point game. And they're wondering about the clock. The officials are talking this over. Tough loss for Montverde, but IMG Academy comes out with a 57-53 win. They get the technical at the end. A couple of
turnovers and 2 for 7 with the foul line. You have a score of about 17-8 with 1 7 turnovers. So -9 there. And they had their 12 for 16 were 2 for 7 from the foul line. Part of that is awareness. We got cut for a layup out of bounds. We got cut for a 4,000 read. We got cut for Jalen's third foul. And then elite, they drove down lane. And we know I got the guy at the ball was driving. It was an easy charge if you were alert. But we got to have alertness to see the ball and see the man at all times on the team.
Where do we go from here? I think we just gotta keep going hard in practice. I feel like I'm excited for May, you know, all the students, they're gonna come out. And I heard it gets pretty crazy, and they didn't let the fans in last year, so it should be extra crazy this year, but I'm super excited.
We looked at yesterday. It was Saturday, my fault, I'm tripping. Wait, man, today's Monday. Nah, but I'm feeling sore, but we gonna get to it in practice. It's game week. We gotta focus, lock in. Win me, because we definitely not losing at home.
Feel good, man. I'm praying to get to work, get down there, finish the season out strong.
Shot has been very purposeful. You know, he's not forcing it.
some words exchanged. Montverde crowd will let you know. Whitehead, again. My goodness, been inside this gymnasium to catch a game.
It's awesome.
I think it's a must-do. It's got to be a bucket list thing. What a sight. So tough to handle. Sky Clark, wide open three, didn't even graze the rim.
I love the defensive intensity by each team. Nothing easy in this game.
Unbelievable. 5 years at Mount Verde and major accomplishment. Probably the most decorated player ever to come out of our program.
Coach came up to me and told me I won a National Naismith Player of the Year. People in 17th, third, they also felt like they deserved it. So I definitely feel like it's going to be a bigger target on my back. But at the end of the day, I don't care about numbers or stats. I just want to go out there and win the national championship.
Again, when you're judging it from Montverde standpoints, and you have, you know, when you're not number one in the country and undefeated, or at most one loss, you know, around campus in the area, it's, you know, you get questions of, you know, what's wrong with the team. So it's, you know, it's a credit to all the past players that have been here that have made the program so good and so high level that if they're not number one, kind of like Alabama in football, what's wrong if you're not in that top spot and if you've lost at all. So this year's team, you know, again, we have a lot of new players. We have a lot of talent, but it's a lot of new players and trying to reestablish a culture that we've had for, you know, 9 or 10 years. Those guys, you know, had to be introduced to that.
Missed spring break to practice for this, so we sacrificed. It'd be foolish as shit to put that sacrifice in, and then you guys go away, and, you know, don't stay prepared mentally and physically. And again, people are watching also how you're behaving, because if you act like a s, they're not looking to deal with that. That immaturity, that this guy needs to get a lot better, and he's immature. It's just not going to work. I'm not giving you $10 million. And you don't know how to, you don't have the seriousness about it. I'm giving you $10 million.
Did you get his thoughts on the last day at Montverde ever?
Nope.
It's not my last day. I got one guy go first.
Later, coach.
Thank you, brother.
Euro out.
Not yet.
This is the hardest one, the first one after traveling, but it's all shit and excuses. Everybody got it. They came from Arizona. Everybody's got a story. Nobody gives a shit about anybody's story. Nobody cares. Nobody cares if six guys are hurt, if KD doesn't play, if Hardy doesn't play, nobody cares. You lost or you won.
Energy.
Hey, I've heard that three, brother.
That
looks like 1, 2, 3.
I've heard. Westry, for the shoot, lost it. Evans in the open floor. Dariq Whitehead punches it. Fallaway jumper. Baltimore from Mekhi Mason. Whitehead, transition opportunity. Dylan Mitchell, the slam. Gorgeous play by Whitehead. A priority. Malik Renaud puts it in for Montverde as they retake the lead. Colin Smith knocks down the three. Enters the Euro. Oh, Dariq Whitehead swallows it whole and gives Lawhorn with the layup. Whitehead engaged for steal and Renaud with the stop. Montverde got it back. Whitehead leads in and scores. Montverde has made 11 appearances at Geico Nationals now. They have never lost in the first round.
I feel amazing. I'm excited. I honestly can't wait. We done lost twice. You know, it's a big game for us. So come out here and get some revenge. You know, it's big stakes. You know, I feel like most people are thinking, like, the winner of this game probably going to go out and win Geico. This is a rivalry game for us, and if we go out here and get the dub on them and then get the Geico, that's just bread on the butter, baby. Like, this is exactly what we need, and I wouldn't want this game to be anywhere else. Like, I wouldn't even want to play them in a championship game. Like, send them home early. They only need to get to go to the championship game. That's how I'm feeling.
Montverde on three, family on six. 1, 2, 3. Montverde. 4, 5, 6.
Family.
Be tough, boys.
Let's go stress.
Both of these teams have won championships before at Geico Nationals. This could be a championship type game. We've got four McDonald's All-Americans. Great matchup in this game. Look at Dariq Whitehead on Keontae George. Zero on the black, on one on the white. NBA prospects in this game, tall stars. The right to move on for a championship.
Make me feel better.
rejected by Walker, but Malik Renew is there. Batchelor in mid-range, and he drains it. Tough angle. Great defense. Rebound. Draven gives Lawhorn for three. The junior committed to Purdue. Joined Montverde in late December. He's giving Montverde a lift in the finals. Mitchell gathers it and puts it in. Howard, little up and under, and one. Whitehead pulls the trigger and connects. 3 seconds to go in the half here. Keontae George launches and hits. Kevin Boyle, Montverde's coach, says, no way that's good.
What are we in? He's trying to look at me. You gotta talk to each other. Okay, and Malik, good job. He's gonna keep fouling you, and you know, hopefully we get some of those calls. All right, we are the better team again. You know, we have the best player in America. We have Naismith All-American. We have the best team, and we just gotta keep doing what we're doing.
To lead all scorers, Renew, the lefty, tend to shoot. Oh, fancy footwork against Walker for two. Montverde got it back. Whitehead leads it and scores. Still with three personals though. Jet Howard flips it in for IMG.
Ongoing allowance.
George leaning in over Evans and he trades another one for three. We're tied. Keontae George soars for two. How about the move by Ja'Cory Hutchinson? IMG has its first lead since it was 5-4. And it's the spin against Batchelor. Oh, erased by Walker. George, three-pointer, good. Now Walker with the steal against Dylan Mitchell, and the powerful finish. IMG with a burst here at the end of the third.
We got no awareness. We get offense, we got mass shooting. Did you block the shot over the top? You don't see it. You don't feel it. You don't see it. Like I'm here. Catching the ball.
Rip to start the fourth. Hood Schaffino, the baseball pass to Draven Gibbs Lawhorn. Emphatic. Whitehead guarded by Hutchinson. Three ball. Money. Dariq Whitehead with his third three. Jalen Hood Schaffino with the layup. Attacking the interior. You think these players want it?
I'm just looking at the action. It's amazing. Whitehead. Basketball IQ. Mid-range ability.
Whitehead to fall away over Howard. That's pure. With the steal. And the future Indiana Hoosier slams it.
Just like in any other championship game, you have to have execution down the stretch. Especially when the talent is even.
The strip. Missed it. Evans missed the follow. Dylan Mitchell, the throwdown. With a third chance, Montverde converts. Renew puts it in. Walker tried to take the charge and knew it early February. George the drive. George off glass. Loose ball. And a foul against IMG as Good Schaffino gets knocked to the floor.
No other team went on the track 4 a.m. in the morning. That shit gotta pay off somehow, y'all. Come on.
First of all, again, tremendous.
It's so good to know, you know, beat a team that beat us twice in a, you know, regular season. But like I said, I'm not going to get too amped about it. The season's not over. Got one more tomorrow, and that's when the whole thing comes together.
Much respect.
Thank you.
Good luck to you.
Thank you. I appreciate you.
Sorry about that.
And then a part of last year's championship team, what's it going to take for you guys, you know, repeat as champions here at the Geico Nationals?
It's going to take a lot of, you know, I think it's more so on the mental part. I feel like, you know, it's a 3 games in 3 days. It's going to be, you know, a lot of people going to get fatigued and tired. And I feel like if we stay mentally strong, then obviously we're going to get that done. That's what we did. That's a tough team. They played, you know, a physical game the whole game. And I was, you know, it was to stay calm. My main thing was to stay calm under pressure and just defend.
Whitehead really played well in Dallas a little while ago over Thanksgiving. Comes off the bench, gives him major energy. Look out! Dariq Whitehead steps in front and he breaks the hammer.
Steal
out of
by
the
Dariq Whitehead. He wants his fourth dunk. He's got it.
Sports Center top 10. He believes that Whitehead will go straight to the lead.
Whitehead gets the rebound for Montverde.
It's been a successful 5 years, I should say. You know, that was the only plan, to come here and make sure I leave a legacy, and I can definitely say I did that.
The Geico National High School Boys Basketball Championship game here in Mars, Illinois. This game features future NBA talent.
Give it all 32 minutes you got, and it should be over. All 32 minutes, and it should be over.
So will it be the first year breakthrough or the continuation of a dynasty in Montverde, led by their head coach Kevin Boyle in his 11th season, an 8-time National Coach of the Year?
We've come a long, long way together, through the hard times and the good.
Dylan Mitchell, the highest flyer in the class of 2022.
But Dariq Whitehead has really worked on his game, improved under Kevin Boyle, been at Montverde for 5 years.
Whitehead against Jordan Wallace, an elite defender. One-on-one, right to the rack. Weak side help gets there late. That's a power out of the rim. Food night on the road, holy bee. Shapiro, skip pass, Kirby Evans Jr., smooth stroke, a three ball for the junior. On the ESPN 60, Ross, the floater, left it short, Mitchell another rebound. Here is Mitchell, slashing to the basket for the throwdown. Transition, but Shapiro leaves it for Renew. Past Jordan Walsh. Draven Gibbs Lawhorn putting it up, and he banks it in. Harris Reed renewed the Euro step, and Lefty puts it home. Mitchell, an offensive rebound, and the soft touch on future Texas Lawhorn. Draven Gibbs Lawhorn is committed to Purdue. Three to shoot. AJ Evans, three ball. He knocks it down. This ball, and scooped up by Dariq Whitehead. Renew, the kick. Whitehead. Wonder! Dariq Whitehead adding that to his arsenal. All-Americans. Renew drops it off and Mitchell lays it in. Meadle skip pass. Courtney Evans Jr. Smooth stroke. Renew the spin. And the lefty scoops it on. Renew in double figures.
How about the footwork?
Whitehead down low. Dylan Mitchell. Defender fell down and Mitchell puts it in.
Finish layup.
Keep
your eye out.
Dropping your chin. First season of varsity play. Renew down low. Whitehead for two. But Montverde is up by six.
Great screen by Hood Shafino. Get Whitehead open.
Under 50 seconds to play. Now, when do you start to foul here?
Not now.
Not with five. Evans. A dagger. KJ Evans knocks it down.
Dylan Mitchell
Kwame Evans, Kevin Boyle with another Geico Nationals championship. Whitehead has been the constant. Didn't shoot it that well today, but the Naismith National Player of the Year, the big buckets late. The dynasty in high school basketball continues. Montverde goes back to back. The Eagles win their sixth Geico National Championship.
He's got four.
Yeah.
No one should win this again, Coach. Come on.
Dariq, how does it feel? Four national championships.
All I got to say is thanks to this man right here. Hey, it was hard at first, but look, got me through it.